Hey everyone, welcome to Cricut Time. If you like this video, subscribe for more project ideas and tutorials on all things Cricut. Hey everyone, today I'll show you how to add flourishes to your writing in Cricut Design Space. Adding these fun accents can really step up your projects, and it's super simple to do. The key to adding accents is in your font choice. Not all fonts have flourishes built in, but there are lots that do. I'll show you how to find out which ones do and how to access them. Today I'm working on a Mac. If you're using a PC or an iPad, just click on one of these links to switch over to my other videos for the platform that works for you instead. Unfortunately, you can't just use the fonts in Design Space. You'll need to download a few new fonts to make this work. There are lots of different websites where you can do this. The one I'll show you today is defont.com. If you haven't used this website before, there are lots of fonts to choose from, and there are categories at the top to make them easier to find. The category that I would recommend for checking out fonts that have flourishes and accents is under Script, right here in Calligraphy. Now you can just scroll down and find a style you like. Some styles will have flourishes, like this little heart in the middle, or when you scroll down, you will notice that lots have tails at the beginning and end of the word, like on Joseph Sophia or Hello. Find one that you want to use for your project. Let's go with Hello Honey, then click on Download. For Mac, you can find this download by clicking this little up arrow right here. I'll double click on this download, and it will open up a folder with the font. There are two different file extensions that are used for fonts. The ones you're looking for either end with OTF or TTF. Sometimes the fonts include both options, in which case you can use either one because they will both work the same for our purposes. Once you've clicked on that, the preview screen will pop up, which shows you what the font will look like. If you're happy with it, you can click on Install. Wait until you're done downloading your fonts, and then open up Cricut Design Space. Now comes the fun part, playing with your new flourishes and accents in Design Space. Start out by clicking on Text. I'll keep it simple today and put in Welcome. Now let's change this font to the one we just downloaded, Hello Honey. Up on the top, you will see the fonts are broken into headings. The Cricut-based fonts are in the first category. You will find yours in the second category, System. Click on that, and you can search the font that you're looking for up here. If you ever try to find your font, but you don't see it there, close Design Space and reopen it again. When the program restarts, it will include your new fonts. So far, this looks pretty plain, so now I'll show you how to spruce it up. At the bottom of your screen, on the menu toolbar, click on Finder. Now type in Font Book in the search bar. You can also do this by clicking the search magnifying glass at the top right side of your screen, and typing Font Book in there. I'll open it, and as you can see here, it has all of your fonts that are on your computer compiled into one convenient location. You can click on any font, and when you scroll down, you can see all of the characters that can be used with that particular font. Many of them will be standard like this one, but others will have special hidden characters ready to go. Let's go down to Hello Honey. As I scroll down, you can see that all the standard letters are here, but when I keep scrolling, there are three other special sets of letters that have flourishes attached to them as well. There is this cute set with the hearts, and then there are the flourishes in front and behind each letter as well. These are super easy to bring into Design Space. I'll just resize my windows so we can see Font Book and Design Space at the same time. Welcome is still here in Design Space, but we want to replace the W and the E with the fancier ones. Let's start with the W. In Font Book, just find the letter that you want to use. I want this W with the tail in front of it. All I have to do is click on it and click on copy. Then I'll go back into Design Space and delete the W. Now I can paste the new W into its place. How easy was that? I'll repeat the process with the E. Just copy it from Fontbook and paste it into Design Space. This looks great and was super simple to do. Now I'll show you how to do the hearts between names. Let's go with Jack and Sally for today's tutorial. I'll split my screen again so you can see both programs. There are quite a few fonts that have little hearts to connect words. You can use these the exact same way. Just find the letter you want to use. For me, it's this K, and copy and paste it in. It's okay how it is now, but I think it would look better if we do the J and the Y as well. Repeat the same process, just copying and pasting these letters into Design Space. There, that looks better. This style is really popular for signs and weddings. Now, before you go and give this a try, there is one more thing I need to tell you. The font that you copied and pasted from Fontbook, needs to be the same font that you're using in Design Space. If you forget, which will likely happen at some point, it will look like this. There will be boxes where the letters with the flourishes should be. This is an easy fix though. Just change your font in Design Space so it matches the one that you copied and pasted from Fontbook. Another tip I can give you is in Fontbook itself. Instead of having to look through the fonts each time, it's way easier to just create a new collection and put the fonts that you like in there. I called my collection Fonts with Accents, and every time I download a new one that I like, I just drag and drop it in here. I'll show you a few that I like to get you started. I like Adelia because it has a few different styles of accents. Samantha is skinny and flowy. And Love is a bit thicker and has lines and hearts. Well, there you have it. Now you can add flourishes and accents to your writing like a pro. Thanks for watching, and if you liked this video, don't forget to subscribe for more project ideas and tutorials on all things Cricut. Also, if you have a favorite font with flourishes, drop it in the comments below. I would love to check it out.